I think that in 2018, it's very important to celebrate stories that are about embracing difference, embracing the other, and coming together in an artistic venture that bonds everybody together. And always to be allowing people to find their true creative voice and allowing people to find their voice within society. And I think we live in very divisive times. I think that so many things are being slowly chipped away at, whether it's individual freedoms on the internet or the way that people relate to each other because we only now speak through text. And this idea of true human connection, I think, is extremely important. ZZ and Johnny, as Fran and Scott, are incredible. I think the chemistry between them is undeniable. And for a story that is about dance and about new steps and about expressing yourself through dance, what beautiful dancers, and how beautifully simpatico and beautifully matched they are as dancers. I mean, it's thrilling. They're virtuosic dancing, they're incredible acting, they're beautiful chemistry, and not to also say that they're both absolutely gorgeous to look at. So you have a combination that's totally unbeatable. You know, a designer is never sad when you get to really spread your wings. So in ballroom dancing, too much is never enough. My husband, Baz Luhrmann, has a great adage, which is taste is the enemy of art. And I think you really see this in all of its glory on stage. And I just love that there are no rules in terms of what you're allowed to mix together. You aren't bounded by traditions of that are imposed upon you, that are sartorial taste lines that you can't cross. And who doesn't love a sparkle? I certainly do. And I love it. What can I say? I feel very comfortable in that world. Well, I know that we have Moulin Rouge in the makings that's coming to Boston, and hopefully that will also eventually have other incarnations. And I know Baz has often talked about bringing Romeo and Juliet to the stage. So who knows? Anything is possible.